Octopuses, and yes, that is the appropriate plural, are some of the most beautiful, mysterious, and absurdly intelligent creatures on this planet. They can change color, they can change shape and texture, they strategize, play, and solve puzzles. They've got three hearts, their skin can see, their blood is blue, their magic trick is disappearing, and over half of their brain is not in their head. Instead, it's in these things. No, they're not tentacles, they're arms. And because they're some of the most fascinating arms in the animal kingdom, today we're gonna wrestle with those. So first, a quick taxonomic rundown. In the cephalopoda class, you've got squid, octopuses, and cuttlefish. Cephalopod literally means head, foot in Greek, and I mean, it kind of works. Octopuses are a bit different from other cephalopods. Squid and cuttlefish actually do have tentacles. Two of those bad boys specifically, which are used for hunting. Tentacles are often longer and kind of slimy with suckers or hooks at their tips. All of those other lanky limbs are arms, used for grappling, grasping, galloping, and generally getting up to mischief. The first thing it's important to know about octopus arms is that they can think on their own. And while this might not sound too surprising when it comes to the third right arm that incidentally functions like a penis, it's a complete departure from how most animals that we consider intelligent operate. Look at your hand. Before you pick up a snack, you think about it, and then your hangry brain sends messages through your spinal cord to your hand, and your fingertips use their few hundred mechanical receptors to achieve the task. Now, if you were an octopus, your fingers would first find the snack, sniff it, decide if it's worth your time, and grab a hold of it. Then maybe be kind enough to inform your brain about the entire thing. Well, the rest of your brain, that is. See, about two-thirds of what we call an octopus's brain, or its neurons at least, are located in its eight arms. For them, this means thinking is a full-body experience. Compared to those few hundred mechanical receptors in your fingertip, each sucker on an octopus has tens of thousands of both chemical and mechanical receptors. This means that they can essentially taste an object as well as feel its texture and weight and decide what to do with it without waiting for a command from the central brain. While the amount varies, the average number of suckers on each arm is over 200. So do a little math, and that's hundreds of millions of sensory cells to explore the world. That's a lot of information. Each sucker is made of two regions. The disc-like part you see is the infundibulum, while the center cavity is called the acetabulum. When an octopus reaches for something, the infundibulum will flatten to feel the surface first. The octopus uses its sucker's acetabulum to attach to the object, with a combination of radial and meridional muscles and tiny hairs that maintain the connection like Velcro. This makes the animal's grip so strong that the largest suckers out there can lift about one Dolores worth of weight each. And did I mention that those arms can regenerate too? With all of their incredible abilities, humans are looking to octopuses to not only better understand intelligence and consciousness, but to inspire innovations in material science, medicine, and especially soft robotics.
There's so many challenging questions in the engineering side we don't know the answers to. Nature has already figured it out, right? So in particular regarding octopus, they've got eight arms, of course. Think about each of these arms have technically infinite degrees of freedom, and controlling a single arm with so many degrees of freedom is a very challenging task for us as engineers.
That's why Hamid and his team are working on developing robots made of hydrogel, which mimic the structure of an octopus's arm.
The interesting thing about hydrogel is you can make it so that it responds to light, mechanical, electrical, and chemical stimulation, just like an octopus. And then what we proposed was to 3D print the entire structure using hydrogel in one shot with embedded neurons made of silver.
If they're successful, this octobot could make huge strides in fields from manufacturing to medicine. Think sensitive, flexible machines that could assist with assembly or surgery. So let's take care of our oceans today to make sure they're healthy for generations to come. Because with so many incredible, strange creatures with such amazing capabilities, who knows where the mysteries of the deep will take us next. Thanks for joining us for this first season of Tusks to Tails. Keep coming back to Seeker for all of your science deep dives, and we'll see you next time.